The sexual culture has undoubtedly changed since the 40s and 50s. But for women, unrealistic expectations and a misguided focus on intercourse remain. So why didn't the sexual revolution fix these problems?
These young baby boomers were not bombarded with the idea that getting married and having children was their patriotic duty, the way their post-war parents were. In particular, the young women of the sexual revolution saw the option of living and working on their own, and of getting more education and being more financially independent than their mothers. They were the product of decades of feminist work, but more importantly to this discussion, they were single, sexy, and out on the town, with no children or husbands to tie them down. Feminist work had broken many of the restrictions on female behavior and dress. This new, sexier lifestyle that seemed to coincide with both the sexual revolution and the women's movement was a pretty palatable one for the established male culture.
However, many women were uncertain that the revolution was really all that liberating.